So we're now at the smallest house in Buenos Aires. As you can see right here. La Casa Mínima. All right. So story has it that the same person that we just seen, the Zafajón, he bought this house. But when he bought this house, he had to buy the whole corner of the street. So he ended up buying it, and he ended up restoring this little house. There's a lot of tales, a lot of myths about this house. One of them is that when the slavery was done, one of the owners gave this little house to his slave. But then later on, it became settlement homes. And this turned out to be one of the best homes because it had its own private bathroom and they lived on their own. Whereas the other settlement homes, there's a series of families living together and sharing the same bathroom and kitchen. So we're gonna go ahead and check this little house out and see what's it all about. Probably not much because it's small.
Ahora vamos a ingresar. Yo voy a entrar por el otro lado y les voy a abrir por acá. Lo que les quiero contar es que hay muchos mitos en el barrio. Hay un mito en esta casa que habla del esclavo liberto. Si ustedes investigan, buscan en Google, van a ver que mucha información dice que esta casita es conocida como la casa del esclavo liberto porque dicen que cuando quedó abolida la esclavitud, las familias que tenían esclavos le dieron una pequeña porción de su casa para que siguieran viviendo allí. O sea, no es que le regalaban, sino que les daban una porción de su casa. Pero eso no hay ningún documento que certifique eso. Nosotros no tenemos ningún documento que diga que la familia Lezica Peña le dio a sus esclavos esta porción de la casa. Sí aparecieron otros documentos y eso es lo que les voy a contar ahora. Y les voy a contar qué tanto de verdad y de fantasía hay en ese mito que habla de esto de que acá vivió un esclavo. Bien, ahora les voy a contar un poco adentro acerca de lo que realmente sabemos y lo que quedó librado, ¿no? A esta fantasía, a esta historia que no sabemos quién la originó tampoco. Bien, ya les abro, ¿eh? Bien.
So overall, this whole place was a mansion, and that little house was part of the whole big mansion. Right now here, I'm currently standing in the patio of the mansion. That wall right behind me was the outside wall of the house. It was a big house, a mansion. The guy that decided to restore all this, he decided to keep that. And when we go up there and we look at it, you'll see a collection of water. And I'm not really too sure, but I guess the water collected up there from the rain, I don't know if it originally that was the plan or it just happened to be, when he decided to keep this wall, he decided to call this as the Fountain of Memory. So this is a little piece of history of Buenos Aires.